During the General Assembly of the Uganda Parliament Circle, the increased number of bad debts came out loudly as sitting and former members of Parliament default on their loan obligations. The Circle Chairperson, Robert Migade Ndugwa, explained that they have had to battle in courts with some MPs to recover Circle money, which is a tall order.
Members of Parliament and former members of Parliament who have actually defaulted on their loans. And our policies are very clear. We have a loan protection fund, but it only works where someone dies with an unpaid loan. And when that person is not in court, if
the General Assembly thus decided not to lend to former members of parliament who don't have savings in the SAC, which is the second biggest in the country, it was found out that defaulting by former MPs has increased as many don't have stable incomes to pay back their loans. Migade explained that former MPs have been getting loans provided they get three guarantors from sitting MPs, but many have defaulted and money is recovered from sitting MPs, which frustrates them to stop guaranteeing their colleagues.
Former member of parliament to borrow, because we are not sure of that member's savings, we have been requiring them to produce three guarantors who are sitting members of parliament. But this one has been a challenge, and many recoveries have had to be done on current or sitting members of parliament. The others are unable to pay back. Now it is very difficult to get someone to guarantee.
Have to ask the board to see how best to ensure that once loans are given out, we are able to recover. The question of sitting or non-sitting or all that, when they do due diligence, then they make decisions that would not lose money. Because now when we start discussing the sitting and non-sitting members, we are going to an area where you can discuss and don't finish it. But when they say, with our judgment, we think if we lend this person with the guarantors or with the securities that are there, then we are able to recover this money.
This was welcomed by some legislators who gave testimonies on how their colleagues landed them in trouble when they guaranteed them to secure credit from the Uganda Parliamentary Circle.
He is working and very smart, but when it reaches issues of payment, our obligations, we duck. So me, I'm still saying, let the savers' money stay and be borrowed by the current MPs.
On record, whereby a sitting member of parliament and a minister borrowed money, we had to recover using legal means. So how do we risk the money of the members to a former member of parliament whose saving may not actually be 50% of what he wants to borrow?
However, the decision was not welcomed by some former MPs wondering why the circle does not consider their sureties like land title and give them loans instead of pushing them to loan sharks. However, the circle management expressed fears of fake land titles, saying they have been victims before.
Look at the criteria whether somebody, I may not be saving, but I come with my land title of 4 billion, I need 50 million. How do you say I have not been
this meeting that even the land titles nowadays are forged? Even when you ask for verification, they give you a verification certificate. You go down, you will not get the land which you are talking about. And you keep on moving. Yes, this is happening in this country. So I think the board needs to be given more ample time to look at the most appropriate option which we can use.
But the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, who graced the general meeting, encouraged legislators to embrace the circle and promote the saving culture as the only way to access cheaper credit that will save them from loan sharks.
That we've learned to have a saving culture within ourselves. And we really want to thank the circle that some of us cannot go and borrow maybe from commercial banks. But when we have a circle like this, we should be able to come and borrow from you or save from you. I mean save with you and borrow from you. Because we may not be having collateral security where we are going to borrow from the commercial banks. We want to thank you so much and ask you kindly to ensure that you keep our money safe.
The Uganda Parliamentary Circle has a membership of over 1,300, including current MPs, former MPs, parliament staff, and former parliament staff. The circle made net profits of 480 million this year. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.